We're here at the Gladstone Institutes in San Francisco, which is an independent institute that is affiliated with UC San Francisco. And my name is Bryce Mendelsohn. Who am I? I am a few things, I guess, at different times. I'm a doctor. I'm a pediatrician and a geneticist, although I'm still completing my training in genetics. I'm a researcher. I have a PhD in genetics, and I do research on energy in cells and how genes influence the way cells make energy. And I'm also a husband and a dad and things like that, a proud Californian. I guess I'm a few different things here. What I do is I work on a problem called energy failure, which is really something that happens in a lot of different diseases where a cell, whether it's a neuron or a heart cell, or any kind of cell really, can't make enough energy. And we're trying to figure out ways to get cells to make more energy, because there are a lot of diseases, whether it's a heart attack or a stroke, or a lot of degenerative diseases or inherited genetic diseases that are at least in part caused by a cell's impaired ability to make energy. That's what I'm doing here. That's in the context of course, my larger career, where I'm also doing some clinical work and hope to combine the research time and the clinical time, seeing patients with genetic diseases and then using genetics to study diseases that we can't treat right now. I was always interested in science. I guess I was kind of nerdy as a kid, but they say the nerds win, so I'm not sorry about how that turned out for me. So I grew up in San Diego, which is a wonderful place to be. It's a terrible place to be from, because everywhere you go has worse weather, even here. I went to college at Emory University in Atlanta. It is a good size that I could get a lot of attention from the professors. It was easy to get into a lab to do research there and get some experience and try it out. So that was a good move for me. And then I went to medical school and graduate school at Washington University in St. Louis, which I mostly went to because the university had a sort of a good package of having a great medical school and a great graduate school. That was also a great experience, a long experience. You save a couple years doing them at the same time, but it took me almost 8 years to complete that. And then at that time, I was ready to come back to California. I'd had enough of seasons. And so I did a pediatrics residency here at UC San Francisco, and then completed a part of a genetics fellowship here also. My research here is in the context of that fellowship. I mean, so science is, was it Edison who said this about, 90% perspiration and 10% inspiration? I could be, don't quote me on that quote, but someone said that. And so that's really the case. So a few hours a week are spent reading the literature, meeting with people, talking over ideas, designing experiments. Okay. Really the bulk of the time is spent with these. Mixing chemicals, mixing biological samples, working with cells, and doing the actual work. That's also a product of the stage of my career. As one moves up, one spends more time using one's brain and less time using one's hands. But it's still rewarding to do the work yourself. And there's a closeness to the project that you don't get if you're just thinking about it and not actually doing it. The advice I would give someone contemplating a career in science is twofold. One, science is a great career. Science is fascinating, it's rewarding, you get to work with people, you get to work with technology. There's just a lot of positive things I can say about it. On the other side, though, is science is very capitalistic, which is that your value is based on what you can do and what you know beyond what other people know. And so you can't go into science where, in the sense that you get a PhD or a master's or a bachelor's and someone just hands you money and a job. It doesn't work that way. You have to distinguish yourself. Science is not a free handout career. There are a lot of jobs. Like I said, you have to really be on the ball to find those jobs and to find one that's suited just for you. But I think that everyone nowadays especially is trying to go into practical careers. And I think science is a good combination of the practical, but also the creative. A lot of people want to be creative, but not everyone can be an artist or a poet. And science is a chance to express yourself, but in a very practical, technological way that is I think, very rewarding, and also you can make a decent living doing that.